If you think it's slow, then do you want me to shut my video also? That will be better. And then I can connect again once if required.
No, no, it's fine. It's perfectly good.
It's fine. So am I audible to all? So very, very good afternoon. And thank you so much, Aircrew, for getting me in here to be speaking to some of the participants on a topic which actually is close to me because I'm an architect by profession with Airport Authority of India. And at present, I'm working as the airport director at Udaipur, which I've just recently joined after completing my AMPAP course and now that I've become a general manager. So what we're gonna be speaking today is actually the deep dive into an airport innovative approach in exceeding customer experience through terminal design, setup and layout. Now, airports are nowhere left as just a point of destination where people just come to take flights and go back. We are actually becoming a complete destination into ourselves. We are also becoming a place where the cities are now recognized by the kind of airports that they have, and they've become landmarks, and they're the ambassador points when you enter any kind of a city or any country for that matter. And the most important part which has come today in the industry is that it's not only hospitality where you believe that you'll be taken care of as customers, but anywhere when you're traveling and you're spending money to pay so much to fly out and go in, you want your experiences to be best. So when it comes to airports, we believe it's through the design, the layout of the terminal buildings, and what are the other elements that we can add, which will add the flavor to your journeys and make them happy. So that, you know, they say when you begin a journey, if it's happy, your whole trip goes good. And if you come through even a little bit of a problem in the beginning of the journey itself, you believe your pain is then going to be running for a very long time. So we believe that the airports should be a place where people should have more smiles than the tears when you are traveling through. So what I always have believed, and your younger generation, which I would like to say is, whenever it's a difficult time, please don't take that as one of the bad elements in your life coming. Please remember, it's actually in the difficulty that lies the opportunity. And that's what Einstein has left and taught us. And when you go through this, it's the innovation is putting it into the creativity that you'd create. So it's very important that whenever you're going through any difficulty or a challenge coming, please start locating for an opportunity in it to grow and to see what more can we do when we want to do this. So when it comes to design, it's again very important, as I said, that you cannot be designing it for one person. We all know that it's not only you traveling alone. It could be design for all, which is universal design. It could be young people, infant, old, PRMs, that's passengers with reduced mobility, anything that it could be. It could also be temporary disabilities for you. So please remember, design comes as a context where it has to be designed for all. Airports are one of those buildings where we don't design for a particular sector of an age or a group. It has to be for everybody. It's, you'll find even a newborn baby will travel with us when they're getting back home if they've gone for delivery, the women elsewhere. So what is that innovation that we look for the universal design? What is it actually? So we always say exploring people is the center design. Whenever you have people for whom that you're designing for, you ought to understand their needs. You know, whenever I talk to people, I always say, let's take it as a layman example. You all design your homes. So when you design your home, please remember, it is your requirement that a designer has to design for, because you're the user. You would want to know and have it as per your criteria and not the fancy of the designer alone. So please remember, universal designs refers to the design and composition of the environment so that it can be accessed, understood to the greatest extent possible by all people regarding their age, size, ability, and disability. Okay, so I missed this one particular out, which is very important. So I think you all are studying MBA. That's what I've been made to understand. So I think design thinking doesn't get out of you anywhere. You'll be much well versed with this particular latest word, which has become the word of the generation. So when we talk design thinking, we are talking of integrating the business and the technology, both for the advantage of the people, because we want happy passengers. If the passengers will be happy, we'll have increased traffic. And if it will be increased traffic, we'll be a successful airport, and it will be a successful, you know, business that we're talking of. So it's not just connecting people, please understand, it's also connecting devices, it's connecting all the kind of other businesses and technology together. So innovation will only work out perfect when you're going to be having your Venn diagrams in place, is what is desirable to the user. So what is it that you want when you're traveling that we can give you, which will make you a happier person? And also then, what is the possible technology that we can get to make the comfort zone levels high for you to travel? Because nowadays, and especially now, when we're talking of the pandemic age era coming into it, we've realized how important technology can be, because then you're actually not touching any other touch point when you're traveling in the airport, but it's your personal mobiles or your laptops or your iPads that you're using and traveling throughout. And also, most important is what is viable in the marketplace. If I get a technology which only few people can understand and use, it's going to be a failure, because most of the people then will not use it. It'll not survive out for the other customers. So one has to know that it has to be something which is viable universally that most of the people can use. Otherwise, getting any kind of technology, per se, believe me, is going to be of no use. It's as simple when you're using different kind of platforms to work on computers. If you're not comfortable, it's of no use to you, even if you say it's the most expensive laptop that you're using in the world. So airport, today's airports is what we talk as a unique 21st century buildings, and we want to get better customer experience just under one roof. So we want to say that the modern airport has a size and intensity. You must have seen the best of the airports coming in the world. If not, I would request you all to, you know, open out your Google text and check out what Beijing is coming out, and China is coming out with a couple of more airports, and to what extent they're building, that they're going to be having more than about 15 to 16 parallel runways. So you can imagine the kind of potential size that we're talking. And from airport, one ventures into the sky and in few hours to any distant destination. So we have a popular saying when we work at the airport, now that you're getting trained in aviation, who says you celebrate birthdays once in one day? You can actually celebrate them twice. Maybe having your tea here in India, and then maybe your dinner and cutting the cake in US. So please understand that these distances have just got curtailed down because of just one technology of flying out. And also in a self-contained urban entity where buildings, roads, businesses, they make remarkable variety of functions. As I told you, airports now are just not meant for passengers to go and come back. See what the airports are as a destination today. See Changi, where they have actually ensured that you can come and do a holiday of 2 days in between the transit and spend time at the airport doing different activities. So you can see the kind of variation in the shift that has come into the building design. So culturally, economically, and socially, the modern airport is a new point of exchange between people, companies, and of course, nations. So just a matrix for you to understand that some of the primary functions that an airport has to have are check-in areas. Of course, you come there to check in, leave your luggage, take your boarding card and move in, security. And wherever there is international travel, you'll have customs and immigrations and the waiting areas. Now, these are primary functions which we have to give in an airport. You cannot do without them. That's a function. That's a linear line of function that belongs to the airport industry. But now coming to the other paraphernalia of secondary requirements. So once you're traveling, people started realizing that the flexibility is very important within the airport, so that all different kind of people can have different kind of sit out areas, eateries, shopping, and the facilities that they want. Accessibility is very important, and accessibility is important for both the people connecting to the city to be reaching the airport, and then the accessibility within the airport. So these are two very important aspects that you look for. So that's why they say increasing furor, airport owners and developers around the globe are reinventing the airport as a place that people actually want to spend time. And that includes the four more kind of time. So you need to realize that if you're going by, you just don't want to go and sit. You know, it's very similar. We don't want to miss those little trailers in the picture when we are going for a movie. So airport terminal is a very complex design system. Please realize this. And the three main formal element that gives a shape to a particular distinct airport is going to be the plan of the airport. So how large it's going to be, how many runways, aprons, etc. The design of the surfaces that you create inside the terminals, because that's what people see as an ambience when you're entering a building, what it looks like. Is the color smooth and it's cool? It's going to give you a warm feeling or it's going to give you a cold feeling. And one other very important aspect is the handling of the light of any particular building. You know, this goes not only just for airports, it goes for any kind of a building that you design in. You always love to be having places which are well lit, which gives you more sunlight, which gives you more natural light. And that is the whole perspective, how the industry has changed from structures becoming into glass and steel. For the reason behind, you want a lot of light pouring in for people to realize how much they can enjoy those kind of vibrancies when the energies are nice. So the plan is basically the geometry. This is absolutely the call of the day where we as designers have to ensure that your design is flexible. So the building can be used sometimes to increase spaces if required within the internal arrangements, and sometimes maybe the place may not be required that much. And you have to understand if they can be put to some other use. So that's going to be one of the important aspects, is the geometry of the space that you're creating. So the people are not claustrophobic in one zone. So it can't be that your check-in area is very small and suddenly your security zone is very big and your waiting area is small. And you realize that actually in security, you need a specific kind of a time and a line arrangement, but you need more space in check-in areas and the sit-outs. If that is not available, then the geometric plan would actually fail for a building. And designing of the surface. Now this calls for a very holistic approach, because various surfaces and materials and circadian lighting adding and maintaining the natural circadian will influence your body function and your, of course, sleep-wake cycle. With your generation, who are awake mostly all of the night, Netflixing it out, would realize that actually daylight is essential for not only your health issues, it's also a very important aspect for the mind development and mind to work. And that's what we want to do when you're traveling through airports. We want, it should be a very smooth journey when you're changing your zone time from one zone to the another. So this aspect is very important when it comes to the surfaces and also the light. So handling of light is also very important. And both these particular areas go hand in glove, because if your surfaces are nice and it's dark and dull, you will not like it. So when your surfaces are warm and they are sparingly large spaces and there's a lot of light, you will see the difference that will show. So this is again something very important that you need to understand, is the approach to developing the new airports. So it's urbanization, that airport is a vector of any city that you're talking on belonging. Security, one of the major issues in today's world when you're traveling is what I should be carrying in my hand, what in my bag, and what is to be happening. Now, when your security goes smooth, your travel becomes seamless and unobstructive. That is the kind of connectivity that we're talking of. And of course, technology. There's a lot of debate running in the industry that people nowadays want to be absolutely self-sufficient and people want to be themselves. They don't want another human walking in to talk, which may be different from my generation. And we always believe there should be some human touch in everything we do. But with technology going so next level, there are some airports which have started believing that people can actually become invisible and be behind the doors and do all the backstage which is required. But a person with his or her absolute smartphones in hand can move around absolutely alone till it's not really required by them to interact with somebody. So technology and mobile and net positivity and possibility of absolute invisible infrastructure and add invisible security. The point of insisting on this is to let you all know that please remember, once you're traveling through the airport, there is nothing called that you're not under the eye scanner, how much ever that you want to be. So because of technology, you may think that there is no other person visible, but then there is something happening behind the door which is keeping an eye on you. Also, innovative terminal design future trends would take care of the passenger experience and humanizing the space. My calls dropped. I'm sorry if I'll have to interrupt for one or two calls in between. It's just because of my duty profile of sitting as an airport director here. Okay, and approach to... Yeah, anything?
No, that's fine. That's perfectly okay.
I'll take in between if it's required, because it sometimes happens you can't avoid some calls. So that I'll do in between. You don't worry. I'll excuse myself for a minute. Okay, so the approach to developing the new concepts, but please do not forget that these are the most important points. Now, you may add all kind of fanciness to your terminals, but if these particular important points are missing, believe me, the passengers are going to have a very difficult time. So your wayfinding signage, that's your communication design, should be in place, because that's the way, if you're new at a particular airport or a building or any passenger traveling, will know what all they need to do stepwise: check-in, security, immigration, customs, and also they will know which gate to go and how and where to go. Multiple vertical transition from public transportation to the gate, airport and airline staff friendliness. As I said, how much ever you say you can go without humans, but still there is a point when you need human hand to hold you and walk you through. Walking distances, we all know, and we all do hate walking a long distance when we know we are carrying bags in our hand, we haven't slept for about 18 hours in a flight. So walking distances and the kind of facility given to cross those corridors is very important. Availability of landside, queues, baggage claim, wait times, and also availability of real-time information pertaining to your wait times is something very important. I must say, we've all becoming a very restless generation. We just want to know when, how fast, how soon it's going to happen. So this is something which we need to take care of at the airport. So it's like whether you are departing in next 20 minutes or 10 minutes, that's also important for you to know, because that makes you a little relaxed after securities to shop also. So urbanization is actually what we call is aviation is driving connectivity in modern cities. There's a very small word, I don't know how many of you've heard, but if you haven't, I would like you to go and look back into Dr. John Krasad's Aerotropolis, a concepts of aerocities which are walking in, where now your airports are actually the point of getting a city getting developed around them. So earlier we used to, you know, tag the airport belongs to that city. Now it's the other way around. The city is going to be belonging to that airport. And they're becoming a multimodal hub. So you just are not flying and coming by air, and then you don't know what next mode of transport is going to be for you. But it's going to be like seamless travel from home to airport and airport to home. So you can get down, you can get train from that airport, you can get those metros, you can get taxis, buses, everything that you would want for. Is there any kind of a problem coming? I don't know. Then there is flexibility. The concept of flexibility actually is a key driver of any successful design, and especially in highly unpredictable environments such as airport terminals. As I told you, this is very specific, of course, to the airport designers who work through, because you need to understand how many passengers you need to accommodate, what are the facilities that you want. So all that is very important. And if you are not flexible, or you're not modular, as they say in the modern language, your terminals can fail you. Because sometimes the traffic can increase and sometimes the traffic can also decrease. So these are some of the flexible designs that we talk of. You adapt for the future needs, and you recognize the major uncertainty of the project and identify the specific section of the design. evaluate flexibility in the design. So all this is actually typical coming as, you know, when you are going to be in marketing, you'll realize how you're going to be even selling your airports to people, that how nice it could be. You'll have all kind of places for all different kind of age groups. This is the kind of flexibility in a common layman language that we're talking of. So maybe I like an area which is secluded. So I get a seating at an airport, though it may be the noisiest airport, but I'll still have a corner, which will maybe have a nice, you know, recliner to sit on, read my book, have my phones getting charged. It's like a private personal space. So those are the kind of flexibilities to that extent is what we need to talk and design. Okay, this is something which was very technical. So I think this slide I'll skip. This is actually meant for people to know how you're going to be getting the change for retail space, interior, finishes. So this is generally meant only for the architects who are designing. Also, one very important aspect in today's world where businesses can shortfall or run through, or you need temporary arrangements. So this is something like temporary relocatable airport terminals, where you can experiment and try a project and built in a structure which can be put there, and that can be now picked up and reused elsewhere. So various schemes which are coming in India now, as you must have heard about regional connectivity, where we are trying to get into the interior and the remotest zone in India to build an airport. We can try the experiment of these buildings, because we know if, just in case, that particular pilot project doesn't work, we'll still not be wasting the infrastructure investment that we've made. So this is also one very important aspect that we need to work on. As I said, complementing flexibility, it's also now changing your mindset to design your furnitures. How you're going to be using modular furnitures and experiment with different kind of furnitures, different colors and different materials at a particular airport. So this is the kind of complementing flexibility that we are talking of. And then it's getting on to intelligent design. Well, I think with artificial intelligence coming and other all technology coming or following you up, the only best example I give you in this is the minute you connect through Wi-Fi at an airport, please remember, you're followed every footstep. There is nothing called privacy left. You will ever not believe it. Technology has taken us to this level that you might feel that your washrooms are going to be a very safe place to go and probably chat with somebody that you want to. But believe me, if you are in the washroom and you've used so many typical words, which doesn't suit the industry in security and safety viewpoint, you'll be caught there also. So please remember, you may have logged in or whatever it is, there is a footstep which is coming behind you. And technology now runs parallelly so strong that your baggage and you both move together at the airport. So they will know that if you are not boarding the flight, your baggage is stopped automatically. So many airports have different technologies of how they're feeding in and how they're working. So please remember, there is nothing called as being not under the eye. And now coming to very important aspect, sociological changes. And I think though this was one lecture I prepared quite some time back, is probably now trying to be falling out true now when the pandemic has come, that now we need to get on to people not standing in two long queues and every paperwork is checked on. But your face is your passport, as they say, or your eyes are your passport, as they say, is getting into the technology of facial recognition or the iris recognition. So even see biometric somewhere down the line is going to get back end now, after now trying to make everything touchless after this pandemic. So you see how progression in the technology is coming and how faster it's coming, that at one time, biometric was something which was really looked upon, that wow, it's latest, just put your thumb and you move. And today we are literally coming to a point of making biometric also redundant in a way, so that we're not supposed to be touching spaces. This also takes us to the next level of becoming very hygiene conscious when we are moving in the world. So some of the future systems which are getting in place, I know how much we all hate, so do I, though I'm an airport director here sitting. We all just don't like when we have to pull out all our, you know, laptops into a different tray and take out all the coins and do everything that's possible. I mean, you just don't appreciate it, your shoes to be pulled out. They're testing all machines now, where a person can actually walk through or just have some scanners and you will move out. So this is something which is becoming actually very, very important. So on a lighter note, I always say you'll walk through and your CT scan is done. And that's what I think everybody's looking for at that 1 minute, where you can just walk through these security booths and you're not to pull out anything, not even your jacket, shoes, laptops. It's just with your handbag. So they're trying to shift technology to a next level where probably your X-ray machines will become redundant after a point when you would only walk through these scanner machines. So technology is limitless and the possibilities that we can go on is also going to be limitless for us. So we have aerospace and defense getting together. Our measurements and instrumentation is going different. Information, consumer technology, healthcare. You'll not believe it. Everything can get connected today when we per se talk technology connecting people. So airports are a destination, as I said, and Aerotropolis. I'll again request you must go and see this concept that airports are becoming a destination. There are a couple of lovely videos that you can watch of Changi 4 of how they've changed the complete definition of the airport terminals. Not only per se technology wise, also the kind of facilities that they per se give. Ambience is very, very important because that's what makes your mood elevated. The natural lighting, as I told you, there'll be nursing stations for mothers, quieter zones for people who like to live. And today there's another aspect, you're traveling with your pets. So you have pet relief areas and well-maintained facilities. So some of the examples that we talk, what airports have done to be different or maybe doing things differently rather. So in New York, you have a terrace, which is there at their Terminal 5. And this place is something where you can even walk your pet. So as per the pet policy that you can carry in your hand. So you have now decided it's not only just humans traveling, it's also your pets traveling with you. Changi, as I said, they have gone beyond a point of creating the benchmark for the industry. They have got gardens and they've used recycling, their roofs, and they have got theaters. They've got everything that you talk of at an airport. They've actually built a city within the airport and they want tourists to come there to even enjoy. So they even have packages like come and enjoy a weekend at the airport. It's to that level of detailing that they've worked for. Incheon has made ice rink where people can go. They also have shower facility, medical facility, golf course, movie theaters, casino, cultural museums, and almost 90 duty-free shops, and they're increasing by the day. So you can imagine this is how the complete different kind of an experience is being created by for the passengers. In Helsinki, they do yoga classes, and they also say that they've been doing a hackathon. San Francisco has got lovely sculptures which they have made, and that's how they entice people to like their terminal building. Dubai is very popular for the kind of light that comes into the building and the kind of design that they have, and the giant palm trees and the kind of whiteness that they create in their buildings. And they have, again, a swimming pool, a gym, a prayer room, children's play area, so you can imagine. Heathrow has used the queue system, the common use system, to the largest extent. So you can check in any counter that you want. That's something which is very efficient way of traveling for any passenger that you would like for. So designing for the 21st century is actually going to be maintaining flexibility. I'd still say inevitably the number of passengers are differently than anticipated. And this is because of new aircraft technologies coming. And please remember for airports, flexibility is important because tomorrow plane sizes can go large They've gone from A320s to A380s to 747 and higher. It can work vice versa, though we never prefer that. But you can imagine that if there is any new aircraft coming, we have to be so up to date with the industry to ensure that we'll be able to handle that. So innovation in every regard, modern airport terminal is vast departure from that from the past. Regarding new terminal projects, identified innovative designs, futuristic in their approach. Passengers should have the processing of the all the required data, you know, like the check-in, the security should be so fast that the speed increases. And then of course your staffing is reduced at times while the customer satisfaction is increasing. Now this can be a very delicate debate, but then that's the way the industry runs. You want the minimum time to have the quality service. You don't want to be in check-in lines for 10 minutes, 20 minutes. You want the minute I enter the gate till my security to shop and get into plane should be minimum time. So that is what each airport is competitively trying to achieve. And to provide easy access between the terminal and intermodal facilities, as I said, we all love it. Let a limousine come outside my house to pick me up, drop me at the airport, and I'm taking an aircraft. Or I would prefer that, oh, if I'm not able to do that, I know there is a metro near my home. I take that metro, I reach the airport. It's like creating a seamless travel to all the kind of multimodal hubs that we have. And the best example for this that I'll give you in the industry from the beginning is Amsterdam, Schiphol Airport. That's something you all really need to see. They were the one who were the set goers when it came to seamless travel. And then passengers desire a lot of choices when it comes to check-in. Well, nowadays we have a benefit to check in from home, print everything or carry it in our hands in our mobiles, which is very important. So you can now see where the shift has come, how the design elements and technology together have changed the approach of any customer reaching airport. You have absolutely finished half your time of checking in at the airport because you have got your boarding card and everything done. You just drop your bag. You just do the security, and then you have so much of time to enjoy and spend at the airports, which have now been designed for you differently with eateries, activities to enjoy. So this is where the design element has changed the perspective of a person going to an airport. Earlier, people used to go check in, security, and take the aircraft. But now people actually route themselves through various airports to shop through those airports. So now you can imagine the kind of shift that we are going in the industry. So passengers desire more choices, check-in, and of course we are shifting to more automated operations. So going and coming to a closure to talk of, we are getting bigger, bolder, automation. We are connected with travelers all the time. I think no traveler wants to be disconnected nowadays, maybe just specifically in the flight time, though there have been explorations to give Wi-Fi even in the aircrafts. Airport cities, they're becoming a reality. There are experiments which have happened in India also. And then we have intelligent airports. As I said, minute you check in, believe me, we are following you everywhere. Retail, that's the new business that is running through. We want you to come, please pamper yourself at airports, check in and enjoy lovely shopping, eat and merry and make your journeys more fruitful. Big data analytic, well, we will know what you like. We will put in through the apps to let you know what you can shop as per your likings. Also ensure you can shop around and we deliver your stuff when the aircraft is about to leave at the boarding gate where you are. So you're not even to carry the weight around when you're roaming about. Integrated security, as I said, these are some of the systems which are running now worldwide, which are important. So the airports of the future is from building airport buildings to the building people. Project engineers take you through the journey. So remembering the key points, the key drivers behind change is behavior, cultural and legislative, and the technology options to help achieve goals. So we transform spaces into living activated experiences. So thank you so much. I hope I could share some bit and you could gather some points. Any hotel at the airport for night stay, awesome information. about many airports in the world. A big thanks to you. Well, yes, many airports have got hotels within the airports. India is coming up with these schemes also now. So Delhi has usually such kind of, hotels are there on the larger airports. So yes, Delhi has, Mumbai has. On smaller airports, it may not be hotels sometimes, but they do surely have sometimes small retiring rooms, kind, that's what they call them, or as restrooms, which can be used. So it's a small bedroom, maybe with a TV and an attached washroom, so that if a passenger has a trouble to travel too far and has a connecting flight, can take rest for some time and carry it forward. So any other question anybody has, you can probably either type or unmute and ask me. You can also feel free, Mr. Shekhar can take questions from you if at any given moment of time, and please you can mail it to my personal email ID and I'll be more than happy to reply you back. So can I bid goodbye now? Am I audible, Mr. Shekhar? Are you there?
Yes, we are very much audible. I'll invite Sakshi to
give okay, what.
Sakshi, you there?
Yes. I would like to express my sincere thanks to Ms. Nandita Bhatt. It was a pleasure to listen to you. I am sure all have gained some insights from this productive webinar. So thank you once again on the behalf of whole AirQ's Aviation
all
Private
right, thank
Company
you so much
for giving
and,
us your
Please have a very good day ahead, and please be all of you be safe. It's very important. Have a nice and a safe Diwali. And yes, let's pollute
Thank
less.
You.